Whether you're a Superman, a Batman, or an X-Man, you'll always find that... Wait, what does being an X-Man, post-op transgender person have to do with superhero movies anyway? And I... Oh, X-Men. This is Movie Night! Hello and welcome to Movie Night, YouTube's number one weekly interactive movie review show. I'm your host, Jonathan Paula. Tonight in the program, we'll be kicking off three straight weeks of superhero films, culminating in an opening day release of the hugely anticipated The Avengers on May 4th. But first, let's start off with the granddaddy of them all, Superman the Movie. Written by Mario Puzo and directed by Richard Donner, this 1978 superhero film paved the way for this astonishingly successful subgenre of cinema, grossing nearly six times its $50 million budget. Christopher Reeve stars as America's favorite alien hero in this 143-minute film that shares Superman's famous origin story. Hollywood legends Marlon Brando and Gene Hackman lend their iconic talents to the superbly made motion picture, bringing some credibility and prominence to their otherwise one-dimensional characters. Lois Lane is played beautifully by Margot Kidder, who effectively anchors this ridiculous fantasy film with a relatable performance filled with wonder and emotion. As the handsome, stoic, heroic Man of Steel, Reeve is both the physical and characteristic embodiment of Superman, never too serious, but clearly invested in helping others.
Excuse me. That's a bad outfit! Okay,
Breslau, I'm moving. God, look up there!
The hell is that?
Easy, miss.
I've got you.
You've got me! Who's got you?
With the first half of this movie focusing entirely on Superman's beginnings, the plot proper doesn't begin in earnest until the 50-minute mark, making the rushed inclusion of a three-act structure with villains, consequences, and reward seem a bit disjointed. Hackman's character especially, the evil Lex Luthor, is curiously hell-bent on destroying all of California, but his motivations are unbelievable, and his actions even more so. Although we're dealing with a comic book adaptation about a magic space alien who can fly, see through walls, and stop bullets, it is unrealistic that Luthor could have figured out Superman's kryptonite weakness and obtain it as fast as he did in this film. Confusing bad guys aside, the individual vignettes in this movie work really well. Brando imparting wisdom to his son in the Fortress of Solitude, Reeve's dorky betrayal of Clark Kent, to Lois Lane and Superman's nighttime flight. Unfortunately though, when pieced together, the movie loses a good deal of its cohesion, sort of aimlessly jumping around from one scene to the next without any real purpose. In 1978, the visual effects here were outstanding, with Superman seen flying around New York, Metropolis, for what seems like the entire second half of the movie. Today, however, much of the poorly lit projection screen sequences rarely look believable. Luckily, John Williams' magnificent and memorable soundtrack is a welcome distraction that glues everything in the movie together, making it easy to overlook some of the cheesier or less cohesive aspects of the film. A fun fantasy tale with an enjoyable romantic subplot, this classic superhero story rightly earned its legacy and is a worthy start to the Superman film franchise, even if the ending is a giant cop-out. Superman the Movie, a fantastic superhero adventure, but disjointed. Well, those are my thoughts on the film. Now let's see what you had to say about it in the YouTube comments. Here's a Red-O-Matic to score Superman. A 7 and an 8. Some mixed opinions here, but overall you really enjoyed this film, citing it as one of the best superhero movies. And despite its overall corniness, you thought it was great. As evidenced by the factor facts, I felt this movie was vastly inconsistent. While I loved the origin story, the dialogue was corny. The visuals and music were standout highlights, but the awkward pacing and unrealistic developments hurt this movie. I thought it was cool though, but just slightly. Our second superhero film tonight is just as important to the genre, Batman. Released in 1989, this Tim Burton adaptation of the famous DC comic book character impressively grossed over $400 million on just a meager $35 million budget. Clocking in at 121 minutes, Michael Keaton stars as Bruce Wayne, a billionaire who vows to avenge his parents' murder by battling crime as the costume vigilante known as Batman. And although he was originally protested by loyal comic fans and arguably upstaged by Christian Bale's portrayal two decades later, Keaton undeniably becomes the Caped Crusader in this film, truly embodying all of the suave sophistication and arrogance of Bruce Wayne, as well as the unflappable determination of Batman himself. As the evil, deranged, lunatic Joker, Jack Nicholson turns in an absolutely unforgettable performance that people still quote to this day, his maniacal laughter bringing to life one of the best villains in cinema history.
You know what happened to this guy, Jack? Made mistakes. Then he had us.
Now you want to get nuts? Come on, let's get nuts.
Tell me something, my friend. You ever dance with the devil in the pale moonlight?
What?
I always ask that of all my prey. I just like the sound of it. Never rub another man's rhubarb.
Skipping right past Batman's origin story, this movie opens up in a pre-existing universe, carefully crafted in the classic Tim Burton style. His treatment and scope of the Batman universe is serious but campy, flashy but gritty, and surprisingly well written to boot. Featuring mostly practical effects, Gotham City looks and feels like its own character here, giving the viewer plenty of eye candy as the super slick Batmobile whizzes down its streets. The trademark gadgets, Batcave, and utility belt all receive a big screen treatment here, much to the delight of longtime fans. While this slower-paced superhero film never quite reaches levels of true intensity or actual suspense, its simple and playful delivery definitely entertains. Outdone only by the recent Christopher Nolan adaptations, this, the first in the long, successful line of Batman films, is easily a worthy entry into the beloved franchise. Batman. Colorfully entertaining, Nicholson is outstanding. Well, that's what I thought about the movie. Now let's see what you had to say about it in the YouTube comments. To show us our scores for Batman, here's the Rate-O-Matic. An 8 and an 8. Your praise for Nicholson's performance as the Joker was unanimous, but the film's faults were harder to nail down, resulting in an average score of great from you. I completely agreed. This is a fun and at times zany version of the Batman universe, but there's something decidedly missing that prevents me from scoring it any higher. But I did think it was pretty great. Progressive chronologically through the years, our third and final superhero film tonight is X-Men. The first in a series of five very successful films whose total gross is $1.8 billion, this 2000 action superhero film is based off the Marvel Comics series of the same name. Bryan Singer directs this rushed 104-minute movie that focuses on the secret life of gifted mutants in America, who hide and live together in a secluded academy, where they affectionately refer to each other as X-Men. This prejudice-based narrative is largely analogous to the American Civil Rights Movement, shining a slightly more serious tone to X-Men's otherwise lively narrative. Lacking a true origin story or a relatable lead character, this sporadically overwhelming motion picture feels more like an average middle chapter of a much larger story. The mammoth cast stars Hugh Jackman, who despite receiving the slight majority of screen time is hardly the film's sole protagonist, as that title is shared amongst Patrick Stewart, Halle Berry, Famke Janssen, James Marsden, and Anna Paquin, all of whom do their best to stand out in their limited roles. Ian McKellen and Rebecca Romijn Stamos are featured as the eccentric villains, who despite being mutants themselves, disagree with their more friendly counterparts.
You must be Wolverine. That remarkable metal doesn't run through your entire body, does it?
With me.
You? My dear boy, whoever said I wanted you?
Inherently, the entertainment from comic book adaptation comes from watching your favorite characters unleash their superpowers on the big screen, with the advent of great special effects and exciting action sequences. Luckily, X-Men delivers on these points in spades, resulting in a truly entertaining film that comic book fans will surely enjoy, culminating in an absurd battle set atop the Statue of Liberty that is as enjoyable as it is preposterous. For non-fans, however, this movie is a confusing mess, spending far too much time developing each member of the supporting cast rather than advancing the plot itself. What you're left with is a fast-paced and flashy action film that is more concerned with a checklist of superpowers rather than creating a genuinely dramatic story. Luckily for the franchise, once this pesky backstory was established, the next four films in the series got progressively better. X-Men is a detrimentally ambitious adaptation, but exciting. Well, those are my thoughts. Now let's see what you had to say about X-Men in the YouTube comments. Here's a Red-O-Matic to rank X-Men, a 6 and an 8. Overlooking the political subtext and cheesy one-liners, you really enjoyed this film's ensemble cast and awesome special effects. You thought it was a great movie. I wasn't as impressed with the flashy effects or action, and the bloated cast really ended up hurting this film in the long run. A well-made motion picture for sure, but the four sequels were unquestionably better. I thought it was good though. Well, that does it for tonight's films. Now let's see what's currently playing in theaters with some of your tweet critiques. Remember, if you're going to the movies this week, make sure to submit your Twitter review using the JPMN hashtag to have it featured on an upcoming episode. Next week, in part two of our superhero special, we'll be examining three comic book adaptations from the 21st century. The original Spider-Man film from 2002 starring Tobey Maguire, 2008's Iron Man with Robert Downey Jr., and Ed Norton's take on The Incredible Hulk, which was also released in 2008. If you haven't already seen these films, I encourage you to watch them this week and let me know what you think about them by voting in the polls below or by leaving me a comment review. And please remember to check out the Movie Night Archive for an organized library of all our past reviews. Once again, my name is Jonathan Paula. Thank you for watching Movie Night. I hope to see you right back here for the next episode.